Very good morning to you. This is your AFN Open Line. I am Senior Airman Eli Smith, and this morning we will be talking with the USAFE Command Chief, Chief Master Sergeant Davis. And I want to say welcome to Chief Master Sergeant Davis right now. Thank you so much for your time this morning, sir, and thank you for being here.
Thank you.
All right, so we have a couple of topics that are facing our airmen today, and we want to discuss those, including the RU Fit program, also the new enlisted evaluation system, Step Up, Step In, and the latest changes in the enlisted PME. So let's start, Chief, if you don't mind, by just talking a little bit of a broad overview of these different topics, and we'll begin with RU Fit. Tell me about the new RU Fit program. What are the things that have been implemented in this new program, and kind of why has it been put in place?
Okay, well, first of all, RU Fit is really not a new program. What we've done is really just taken comprehensive airman fitness and looked at it and said, okay, how do we make it so that it resonates with our people, with our airmen? And so, you know, we had our PH staff take a look at it, and what they came up with is RU Fit. And what we're trying to say is, are you fit in your personal life? Are you fit in your family life? Are you fit with your coworkers? So we're not trying to take away from comprehensive airman fitness, because all those pillars within comprehensive airman fitness, or CAF as we call it, are embedded in Are You Fit? And so really it's just the, you know, we're not taking away from the program itself, but we've just changed the name to have more effect.
All right, so the name has changed, but you said the effects have remained the same and are even growing a little bit more. So we'll talk more in depth about RU Fit here in just a little bit as well. And we have some questions for you this morning, Chief. Obviously, this is the open line, so we want to invite anyone who's listening from around Europe to give us a call and ask us your questions. You can call DSN 489-6353, and we will get your questions answered as we move throughout the morning. Also taking questions on Facebook this morning, and that Facebook page would be AFN Kaiserslautern, the Eagle Morning Show. And so go ahead and write in your question as a private message there, and we'll get to your question on any of these great topics. Like we said, we're talking about RU Fit, the RU Fit program, the new enlisted evaluation system, and the Step Up, Step In, as well as the latest changes to the enlisted PME. So let's move on now to kind of a broad overview of this new enlisted evaluation system, something that everybody has a lot of questions about. And, you know, we've already had quite a few emails that we're going to try to get to as many as possible of them this morning in our open line. But talk about the new enlisted evaluation system, what it means, what the purpose behind it was.
Well, you know, as the Chief of Staff of the United States Air Force and the Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force have traveled around, one of the things that airmen talked about the most was a change in our enlisted evaluation system. Everybody felt like the program was overinflated. So the Enlisted Board of Directors, Headquarters Air Force, we all began to take a look at our EPR as it sits today, the Enlisted Performance Report today, and for the most part, the majority of our airmen receive an overall 5. And so the worst thing that you can have is someone who is performing at the top of their game and someone who is a mediocre performer both get the same EPR rating or listed performance report rating. So with that in mind, we began to look at the new enlisted evaluation system as we have been rolling it out over time. And we've been trying to make sure that we don't just rip the Band-Aid off, but move into the new process where we look at force distribution. That way, everybody will not be considered an overall 5, but when you start looking at the breakdown itself, you will have 5% of your airmen that will receive a promote now. 15% of those airmen will receive a must promote, and then the remaining will receive promote. So with that, we're looking for a fair balance, but there will be a distinct advantage. When you're talking about a promote now and a separation of 250 points, you know, for the top performer and 200 points for those that receive promote now. So it will be a decided advantage, but that's only going to be a small amount of personnel.
All right. So some interesting changes. And Chief, we do have a phone call now coming in. And I'm being told that it is A1C Saunders from Lodges who has a question about the new EPR system, since we are discussing that now. And so if you don't mind, sir, do you mind taking a question on this EPR?
Okay.
This is Airman First Class Kyle Saunders calling in from Lodges Field in regards to the EPR system. So I was curious if airmen coming into the new EPR system will be at a promotional disadvantage when up against airmen with EPRs from both the new and the old system with the way that they're making these changes.
Okay, I'm sorry. There was a little bit of cutting in and out there. I don't know if you heard that entire thing there, Chief. But what he was asking specifically, I think, if I got the whole thing, was in the new EPR system, basically, is there going to be, for airmen who are up for promotion, is there going to be a disadvantage because they're going up against some airmen who have EPRs from both the old system that you're talking about being inflated and the new system as well? So will there be a disadvantage to brand new airmen, I think, is what he was getting at there.
No, a quick answer on that is no. They won't be placed at a disadvantage. We're going to look at the top three EPRs. The top EPR is going to be worth 50%. The second is 30%, and so forth and so on. If an individual only has one EPR on top, that EPR is going to be worth 100%. And if you happen to have two EPRs on top, you know, we will look at that percentage on that as well, being 60% for the first one and 40% for the second EPR.
Okay. And, you know, from your personal perspective, you said that it is inflated, or it was inflated, excuse me, and that was kind of the main reason for the change. Can you tell me some of the ways that you're guarding against that from happening again in the new EPR system?
Okay. Going back to what I stated earlier, the force distribution, that's going to actually prevent the overinflation, because not everybody is going to have the opportunity to receive the top percentile. And as we look at it and we look at our commanders who are going to be in charge of this program, they're going to have a big responsibility, but not just with our commanders, but also with our senior leaders in those organizations. They're going to have to make the right call. When they see the top performers performing, they have to reward them accordingly. And I know that concerns a lot of people, because we're talking about the trust factor. And we have to gain the trust of our senior leaders in those organizations to make sure that they're going to do the right thing. So this program will be monitored at the same time, because that commander or senior leader in the organization will only be given the percent of personnel that are promotion eligible within their organization. So they won't be allowed to go outside of those lines.
All right. And I'm being shown another question here now that is has come across in a message about the EPR system. So, and it goes along with kind of what you were talking about there. With the new EPR system, what is the overall effect that you and other senior leadership are aiming to have on promotions in general? And sorry, this is a two-parter here. And also, how will this new system affect airmen who have an approving official at another location? So the first part of that, what's your main goal, I think, is what we're being asked. And that was coming from the UK there. So we're getting questions from all around Europe here, and trying to get some our best answers out to you here in the AFN open line. So please be patient. We will get to your question as quickly as possible. But, Chief, so the question was, with the new EPR system, what is the overall effect you and other senior leadership are aiming to have on promotions overall? And also, will it have an effect on airmen who have an approving official at another location?
To recognize our top performers, that's the bottom line. That's the only reason why we're doing what we're doing. Right now, we can't discern between number one and number 10, because everybody has a five. But when you start looking at, you know, the promote now, the must promote, and promotes, there's going to be an advantage, as I stated earlier. So that's the overall goal, to make sure that we recognize our top performers. If you have someone who has a supervisor at another location, we're still going to make sure that those individuals, they're going to have the Airman Comprehensive Assessment feedback. So that feedback form will go forward along with that EPR. And the leaders that are on the ground will help that commander that is forward or in another location make the decision on the performance of their individuals. And I know that this causes a lot of concern with our folks, because we do have people that are in geographically separated units or organizations, and they don't get a chance to see their commanders or their leaders every day. But it's going to take that extra effort from the leadership to make sure that they are making sure, putting an eye on their personnel.
Absolutely. So it does come down to leadership in that particular aspect.
It's all about leadership.
Exactly, of course. And what did you say, though? You know, it is difficult when you're talking about evaluations to imagine being evaluated by someone who you don't see. So, I mean, very reasonable question there, and great answer to, you know, hit on that topic specifically, because it would be a huge worry if you had someone evaluating you in another place that doesn't see you every day, because there are particular things that each of us do in it, you know, in and out of every single day that people here in shop would recognize and see.
Right.
And so, of course, someone in another location isn't going to pick up on those things as readily. But like you said, it falls down to leadership.
And the supervisors, they still have to do their job. You know, they've got to make sure that they're taking care of their airmen.
Absolutely. All right. So we're talking this morning with the USAFE Command Chief, Chief Master Sergeant Davis. And we are in open line this morning. AFN's open line gives you the opportunity to ask the chief questions about all the topics facing today's airmen, including the new Are You Fit program, the new enlisted evaluation system, Step Up, Step In, and the latest changes to the enlisted PME. And so if you do have a call, please call us 0631-536-6353 or DSN, 489-6353. Give us a call if you have a question for Chief Davis. And so, Chief, we want to move back to, we talked a little bit about the Are You Fit program not too long ago. You were, as we opened this morning, you discussed that just a little bit. But we have a question coming in now from Aviano. And so I wanted to open the phone lines one more time and just get this question. It's from, I'm looking at my notes here, it's from A1C Cole from Aviano. So let's go to the phone lines now. And A1C, please just ask your question, and then we'll turn it back over to the chief.
Hello, sir. This is Airman First Class Benjamin Cole from the Aviano DFAC. And I had a question about your Are You Fit campaign. As airmen in the military, we have the same priorities in our day-to-day life, wanting to better our fitness mentally, physically, spiritually, and socially. And my question goes to the families of the airmen. How is your Are You Fit campaign, how does it translate to our families and wanting to better their fitness in all those areas?
All right. So thank you for the question. That was A1C Cole, once again, from Aviano. And so, Chief, he's asking basically, how does this spill over into our family lives?
You know, we're connected. You know, when you're talking about an airman, you have to include the family member, because a healthy airman equates to a healthy mission getting done every day. And so if we look at, you know, our family side of that, if you have chaos going on in the family, if the family is not physically, mentally, spiritually fit, and then that airman is not going to be fit as well. So when they come to work, their resilience is not going to be where it needs to be. Their readiness is not going to be where it needs to be. So when we talk about, this is a holistic approach, looking at the entire family. So it has to be tied in together. But also in Airman Cole's opening comments, he said your fitness or your Are You Fit program. It's not my Are You Fit program, but it's a USAFE Are You Fit program. It belongs to everybody. So we want people to own this. And we really put it out there that it's not just another tagline, but we want it to be a way of life. And if it's going to be a way of life, that means it has to resonate in your families, in your daily life, in everything that you do. So a healthy airman carries across the full spectrum, not just at work, but at home as well.
Absolutely. Another great answer there. We're talking this morning in our AFN open line with the USAFE Command Chief. That is Chief Master Sergeant Davis. And we will be back in just a couple minutes. Going to take a quick break and be back to talk more about all the topics facing today's airmen, including the new Are You Fit program, the new enlisted evaluation system, Step Up, Step In, and the latest changes to the enlisted PME. Keep it right here. We'll be back with Chief Davis in just a few minutes.